After what SpaceX's founder, Elon Musk, called an embarrassing glitch with Starhopper, an experimental rocket ship, the company pulled off an impressive launch and landed on the 27th of August, Tuesday. The SpaceX Starhopper rocket took to the skies for a second time, reaching a height of a small skyscraper before landing back to Earth. The flight demonstrated the vehicle's ability to take off and land in a controlled manner, and it paves the way for more aggressive testing of the vehicle's design in the months ahead, as Elon Musk's company moves ever closer to reaching the Red Planet. "Congrats, SpaceX team," Musk tweeted shortly after the attempt. "One day, Starship will land on the rusty sands of Mars." Starhopper is a roughly 60-foot-tall, 18-meters, vehicle, and a squat steel prototype of a planned Mars launch system called Starship. It's located at SpaceX's rocket launch and development facility near Boca Chica Beach, Texas, at the southeastern tip of the state. In this video, Engineering Today will discuss SpaceX Starhopper rocket prototype, which takes giant leap for Elon Musk's team to land on the rusty sands of Mars. Let's get into the details. The test, commonly referred to as a hop test, marked the highest flight yet of SpaceX's prototype, Starhopper. Equipped with one main Raptor engine, the vehicle flew for the first time on July 25th, but it only got about 60 feet, or 18 meters, off the ground, and the entire scene was shrouded in plumes of exhaust. Tuesday, SpaceX Starhopper provided a more impressive sight when it took off from a pad at SpaceX's test site near Brownsville in Boca Chica, Texas. The vehicle took off vertically, slowly climbing near to its target altitude. Once there, the vehicle hovered in the air for a full minute, translated a short distance before using its Raptor engine to land gently back down on a different pad, proving it can maneuver while hovering. The long-awaited test was intended to go to an altitude of 500 feet, or 150 meters, although it was not immediately clear from the webcast of the flight exactly what altitude the vehicle achieved. The company provided no commentary for the webcast and ended it shortly after the vehicle made what appeared to be a successful landing. Musk said Tuesday's launch, "While the flight appeared to be a success, SpaceX has no plans to fly Starhopper again." The company will now move on to testing bigger and more capable prototypes in pursuit of Starship. Its hope within the next few years is to develop a final version of the fully reusable two-stage launch system. This SpaceX Starhopper's tests are supposed to evaluate the design and hardware that'll be used on the company's future Starship rocket. SpaceX is developing the monster spaceship to send people and cargo to deep space destinations like the Moon and Mars. Towering around 180 feet or 55 meters tall, Starship is meant to launch from Earth on top of a giant rocket booster called Super Heavy. When it reaches other worlds, the vehicle will land upright with its onboard methane and oxygen-burning Raptor rocket engines, similar to how SpaceX's Falcon 9 rockets land on the ground today. It's also supposed to take off again from these distant destinations to return to Earth. But first, SpaceX needs to thoroughly test its core technologies, many of which are new, including the Raptor engine. This SpaceX Starhopper has only been flying with one Raptor. Soon, SpaceX will add more engines to its test flights. The final Starship design calls for the spaceship to have 6 Raptor engines. 3 will be optimized to work best in our planet's atmosphere at sea level, and the other 3 will be designed to work best in the vacuum of space. Starhopper lifted off at about 6:02 p.m. Eastern Time on Tuesday, or 5:02 p.m. local time, then landed about 57 seconds later. SpaceX's full video of the launch showed several live views of the stubby steel rocket ship and its lone Raptor rocket engine taking off. As the engine ignites, the launch throws up a thick cloud of fumes and dust. The video then cuts to an aerial drone view of the launch pad as Starhopper ascends. The vehicle then gimbals, or steers, its Raptor engine to move up and eastward as reaction control thrusters, seen as puffs of white smoke, keep the vehicle righted. Then, in another chaotic cloud of dust and smoke, lands on a concrete pad a few hundred feet away. SpaceX attempted to fly Starhopper on August 26th, Monday, but the attempt was scrubbed after the Raptor engine failed to ignite, just 0.8 seconds left in the countdown. SpaceX chief executive Elon Musk later tweeted that dual redundant torch igniters in the Raptor engine appeared to have malfunctioned and needed to be inspected before trying again. "Igniters will be inspected. We'll try again tomorrow, same time," Musk tweeted on Monday following the scrub. He added that the cause was probably a wiring or connector issue. Overnight, he responded to a Twitter user who questioned why there weren't any sensors or other checks on the devices, which are crucial to the rocket taking off, to verify they're working. "Yes, rather embarrassing," Musk replied. Whatever SpaceX workers did to correct the glitch apparently worked, though. And now, the Starhopper's final flight in the can, SpaceX can move forward with attaching more of its Raptor engines to bigger and more capable prototypes. The company's been building two new Starship prototype rockets, one at the South Texas site and the other at an industrial site in Cocoa, Florida. The Florida version of Starship will be taken by truck and barge to Cape Canaveral for test flights. These two test vehicles are a bit more robust than the SpaceX Starhopper, which was never meant to be a faithful replica of Starship. Now SpaceX is working towards launching a larger prototype called Starship Mark 1, which will use three Raptor rocket engines and be capable of launching from the Texas site, flying around Earth and landing back there. SpaceX is building a similar yet competing prototype in Florida called Starship Mark 2. The newer prototypes will be equipped with grid fins for steering and better landing gear. The two are meant to perform a series of hop tests that could reach as high as 12 miles or 20 kilometers up in the months ahead. Eventually, SpaceX will fly prototypes that are supposed to achieve orbit during the first launch to space. Once SpaceX finishes the Super Heavy booster, SpaceX CEO Elon Musk also noted that the two teams building these prototypes are in a friendly race to reach space first. However, the rules aren't super strict. It seems a success by both in close proximity would be amazing, and each would count as a win, Musk tweeted in August. Before SpaceX can launch either rudimentary rocket ship or any full-scale starships, the company needs sign-off from the Federal Aviation Administration, FAA. Working on regulatory approval for both Boca Chica, Texas and Cape Kennedy, Florida, Musk tweeted in March, "We'll also be building Starship and Super Heavy simultaneously in both locations. Those vehicles are all stepping stones to Starship, a roughly 18-story spaceship, and Super Heavy, a roughly 23-story booster. The launch system is also being designed for full reusability, which may vastly reduce the cost of accessing space." SpaceX fired up Starhopper for the first time in April. That test secured the rocket ship with giant bike chain-like tethers on its legs, and the vehicle lifted just a few inches off the ground. On July 25th, the vehicle made its first free flight, rising about 60 feet or 18 meters off the pad before landing about 10 to 15 seconds later. At the time, Musk said he expected a hop to an altitude of 200 meters in a week or two. This flight, though, was delayed by issues amending the company's experimental permit issued by the FAA's Office of Commercial Space Transportation. "Need a bit more hazard analysis and should be clear to fly soon," Musk tweeted August 15th. That revised permit was issued by the FAA August 23rd, but limited SpaceX to a single flight of the vehicle to 150 meters altitude. The permit also increased the third-party liability insurance requirement from $3 million to $100 million, reflecting the apparently greater potential damage the vehicle could do in the event of an accident. SpaceX's South Texas site is unusual in that people live within a few kilometers of what the company eventually plans to be an orbital spaceport, in a subdivision called Boca Chica Village that predates the site by decades. Residents of the subdivision reported on social media that they were informed by local law enforcement to stand outside of their homes during the test, in case there were any problems with the launch, which would have caused a shockwave that shattered nearby windows. Fortunately, there didn't turn out to be any problems. The SpaceX gracefully took to the air after its engine roared to life, rising high above the ground before shimmying sideways and coming in for a gentle landing. As the smoke cleared, the vehicle looked in good condition, and it will now be retired after a job well done. Workers will soon cannibalize it for parts and turn it into a peculiar-looking test stand for Raptor engines that will power SpaceX's rockets of the future. Now that this latest test is complete, Musk is poised to give an update on the Starship's design and progress. Originally, he planned to give a talk at Boca Chica on August 24th, following the 500-foot flight. However, Musk pushed back that event after the Federal Aviation Administration was slow to approve Starhopper's flight, forcing SpaceX to delay the test until Monday, August 26th. Musk recently suggested it would be better to hold the event once the Starship Mark I vehicle at the site had three Raptor engines installed, along with other components. Musk estimated that to be completed in mid-September. We'll all be watching with bated breath to see what comes next. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.